Hey, how's it going? It's Jordan Lumi here. I'm the Young Adults Pastor at Fellowship Missionary Church, and this is my devotional series called Trapped in Quarantine. Each week I've been putting out devotional videos just to encourage you guys while you've been trapped in quarantine. Well, last week I made a video called Dealing with Conflict, because let's be honest, when we're trapped in close quarters with people for a long period of time, I don't care if you love them a ton, there's going to be conflict. There's going to be things you disagree about. There's going to be things that those people do that drive you nuts. And so I thought it was important to include in the package of these devotional series some tips on dealing with conflict. Well, this week we're going to expand a little further on that thought. And if you have your Bibles, you can turn to Matthew chapter 5, verse 9. We're only going to look at one verse. And it says this: "Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called the children of God." You will know somebody is a child of God by their ability to make peace in a situation. Now, I think it's important to note the wording in this passage. It says, "Blessed are the peacemakers." It doesn't say, "Blessed are the peacekeepers." And that's important to distinguish the difference. See, peacekeeping and peacemaking are two very different things. Peacemaking means there was no peace in the first place, and we made that peace. Now, it takes a specific type of intentionality and humility to actually make peace. Keeping peace, on the other hand, is actually a very easy thing to do. All you have to do is avoid conflict, and that will give you the type of peace that the world seeks after. But God seeks a deeper peace. What I'm saying is, in order to have peace, sometimes you have to go down the uncomfortable path of confrontation. But this leads to true and godly peace. This is why the scriptures in Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6 called Jesus the Prince of Peace. But then in Matthew chapter 10, verse 34, Jesus says, "I didn't come to bring peace, I came to bring a sword." Now, this seems like an apparent paradox, but Jesus didn't come to bring the peace that the world seeks after. He wanted to bring a peace that goes deeper, a peace that brings joy. And Jesus wasn't the type of person that would shy away from a hard situation or a hard confrontation. In fact, just look at him with the Pharisees. Jesus is extremely confrontational. And I don't know about you, but sometimes when I'm reading the things that Jesus says to the Pharisees, it makes me cringe. I can almost feel myself in that moment. This is what John chapter 1, verse 14 says, is that Jesus came to bring both grace and truth. Peace is not the absence of truth. You need truth in order to bring long-lasting and true peace. But grace is the way we administer that truth to people. It's the technique you use. It's the being able to ask questions and understand where the other person came from. If we just settle into peacekeeping, meaning every time there's a conflict, we just avoid confronting it, then bitterness will build up in our hearts. We talked about Matthew 18 last week, where we said, if you have a conflict with another person, you need to go to that person and deal with that conflict. This is what peacemaking is. Peacemaking isn't avoiding conflict, but it's walking through it to bring long-lasting peace. Ultimately, those who avoid conflict in hard situations, these are not the peacemakers that the Bible talks about. But this is a characteristic of what it means to be a child of God. We have to learn to step into hard conversations and hard situations. And if we are faithful to do that and trust the Lord, He will bring long-lasting peace. Amen.